Hey everybody, it's All About Vehicles here, and today I'll be talking to you about what I think about 4x4s, rear-wheel drive, two-wheel drive, front-wheel drive vehicles, and all that jazz. So, first of all, 4x4s are complicated, because they have an actual, if it's an actual 4x4, we're talking pickup trucks here, like, you know, Ram, Chevys, Fords, right? They have something called a transfer case, you know? The vehicle's rear-wheel drive bias, it goes engine, transmission, transfer case, drive shaft to the rear end, and then it splits with a front drive shaft to the front axle. So what happens is when you engage 4x4, not only is the rear drive shaft spinning to turn your rear wheels, the front one is turning to turn your front wheels. That's 4x4. Two-wheel drive or two-wheel drive only vehicles are either rear-wheel drive, two-wheel drive, the term used in this case would be rear-wheel drive. So rear-wheel drive are vehicles that literally only are one-wheel peel, as we call it, one-wheel peel, only one-wheel spins. So really it's supposed to be both the two rear wheels in the vehicle are the only two wheels that are your drive wheels. There's no 4x4, there's no front, you know, differential, nothing. All-wheel drive vehicles are either front-wheel drive or rear-wheel drive bias, which means the two front wheels or the two rear wheels are what turn as the standard, like what that will happen first, and then they start slipping either the front or the rear, depending on which wheels are, you know, not the drive wheels, will start spinning as you lose traction, therefore helping you get out of your sticky situation. Now, there's also front-wheel drive vehicles, another version of one-wheel peel. Two front drive wheels, but really it's a what they call a transaxle, therefore it's the engine and the transmission mount on the same axle, therefore the engine sideways. The drive belt will be on the passenger side instead of the front of this engine, which is okay. You can get used to it. I don't mind it. But they're great in winter if you've got winter tires. So it is beneficial. I do like it. So, you know, one wheel peel, just the driver's side tire that only spins, whatever. It's going to be what it's going to be. So if I had to pick one version of drive system in Ontario, especially with harsh winters, it'd have to be 4x4. Why not all-wheel drive, you may ask? Well, 4x4, it's dependable on the way that you're going to have that 4x4 when you need it. There's more capability with 4x4. You can go off-road, especially if it's a truck. So you have more options, so to speak. So with all-wheel drive, yeah, it's great to get you through snow and mud and whatever. But at the end of the day, you know, if you need to do some, you know, light off-roading, you need a truck, okay? So, or actually hardcore off-roading, you need any kind of truck with 4x4 and, you know, solid axles and, you know, lift kits and all that jazz. If I was just whizzing around the city, especially in winter time, I'm talking about like Northern Ontario, like Sudbury, that you really do need 4x4 in the winter. Around here in the city, all the roads are plowed, so you don't really need 4x4. All-wheel drive can be recommended, but front-wheel drive or two-wheel drive or rear-wheel drive is okay. So, if you live here in Upper Canada, as I call it, if you live in Canada, where we have harsh winters in every province, in every territory, and you need the dependability of a truck, you're going to have 4x4. And 4x4, quite frankly, is probably the best option around here, even if you do live in the city. My father's truck is a 4x4, and he does love it, because with all the weight with the city, sometimes not all the streets are plowed, or, you know, you go down some back road and it's not plowed, and you need to get down that back road to get somewhere, right? It helps. So I'm All About Vehicles. I'll talk to you guys later. Have a good day, and bye. And I'm live at 6:30. Bye.